Welcome, my dear guests. My name is Bradshaw King, and did you know that at maximum speed, a cheetah would spend more time flying than on the ground? Well, I guess I had an idea about this before, but I probably forgot about it. Also, my throat is sore. Wonderful. Anyway, that was the this week's random fact. That was the random fact of the week. I'm sorry if it wasn't that interesting for you, but if you think about it, it's a bit interesting that a terrestrial animal would, at maximum speed, it gets so fast that it spends more time in the air than on the ground. Anyway, sorry for not uploading in a while, but I have some problems with my computer. It keeps overheating. And it got to the point where, although it has 4 fans, I also have to use my own fan in order to cool it down. Because it gets too hot and it stops. Well, this problem is rather old, but now it got a bit worse, I'm not even sure anymore. Anyway, enough about technical difficulties. You are here to be entertained. Seriously, now what's wrong with my throat? Anyway, tonight we are playing The Shadows That Run Alongside Our Car. And I'm not going to lie, I saw Jacksepticeye play this game, but he played only from one perspective. I will play from the other, and you will understand soon what I mean. Choose whose eyes will you see the road through. Click one. You see, Jack played this girl. Wow, her eyes move really fast. And now I'm going to play this guy. Gun it. Sorry, it will be rather hard to do voices, but let's try. I put the pedal to the floor. The wheel scratches as we pull out into the lane. The car swerves, but it doesn't really matter. Wait. There's no one else out here as far as the eye can see. Ah. The abandoned station shrinks behind us until it's gone. And then it's just us in the long road. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. The world outside the windows passes by us in abstract, like the whole world's given up on having any meaning. We drive in silence. After a while, I hear the faint buzzing of the power window being rolled down. You sure that's a good idea? It's not like zombies are just going to hurl themselves at a moving car. Fair enough. Well, that was a thrilling conversation. So, guess this is kinda strange to be asking after 3 whole days, but what's your name, anyway? Right, we never did introduce ourselves. It's Shelby? Nah. Shelby. Maybe she looks a bit like a Shelby, but I don't know. Let's call her Anna. Anna. And Anna. Well, nice to officially meet you then, Anna. Name's Dusty. You know, whatever. Dusty. Okay. Wow, what a meaningful conversation. Seriously, now. So from what I understand, you've been traveling together. By the way, from what I understand, this is some kind of zombie apocalypse. So they've been traveling together for 3 days. And they don't have any kind of... They can't have any kind of meaningful conversation. Seriously, now, how boring. Please, entertain yourselves. Do something entertaining. There's a thing about me. I hate when my friends tell me that they're bored. Because I know the feeling of boredom and I hate it. And for some reason when I hear that my friends are bored, I feel bad for some reason. I'm supposed to be heartless. Anyway. The car. I guess that's some kind of remains of the discarded humanity. Anyway, the car shudders briefly as we rumble over a series of potholes, but then the road smooths again. The humming of the engine reminds me of a storm brewing far off on the horizon. Beyond these occasional noises, we still in silence. So, what were you doing before everything happened? Oh? Whoa, that's the first time she's actually started a conversation. Guess I'm not so intimidating after all. What was I doing? God, what was I doing? What was I? A whole lot of nothing. I bet that sounds super impressive, huh? Just a scruffy drifter. Not so sure she wants to hear that. Bend the truth, dodge the question. Either dodge the question or bend the truth. Bend the truth. I was moving cross country. Then everything went south. What about you? This ride is yours, right? I'm sorry, but I don't want to. If I dodged the question, I think I would have ended the conversation or something like that. And I don't want the conversation to end right now. I mean, seriously now. They finally started to speak. What about you? This ride is yours, right? Yeah, well, it's really my dad's car. Or was. Even when he was alive, though. I was the only one who ever drove it. Ah, guess he didn't. Sorry, never mind. It's okay, the booze would have killed him eventually anyway. Wow. Wow. They are really having a party. Pretty quiet in here, huh? Surprisingly, not much noise at the end of the world. Do you think there's any radio stations left? Sorry, I'm a bit tired. I'd better I'd be pretty shocked if so. Reckon it couldn't hurt to look, though. She's fiddling with the dial. I'm pretty sure we're not gonna find anything. City comes, static comes in and out in waves. Every so often the distortion gives the illusion of a natural sound, but then it goes right back to nothingness. Just then though, hang on a sec, go back down. I think I actually heard something. Oh. The noise phases in and out, then as something comes into auditory focus. Is that mariachi? Hey, they're smiling. This is not really the kind of smile that would annoy me. At least this is a smile born out of, well, like a ray of hope in desperation, in all their despair. Anyway, I actually like this song. You can't see me now because I don't use the mask cam, but I'm dancing a bit. I really enjoy this song. I can't contain myself. The sound is unmistakable. Horns blare joyously over the static in a sick fanfare, while a man's voice wails soulfully over it. I'm laughing so hard, I nearly piss myself. Anna's nearly there too. That was not what I was expecting. Who the hell's out there running this? Of all the music that would be left? Man. I sink back into the driver's seat, letting my mind drift to the music. The dissonance is almost comforting. I really like this. As the fractured chords wash over me, I try to pretend that I'm lounging in a truck bed somewhere. I just love how it starts. Out in the sun, mid-afternoon. Shirt damp and dirty from a hard day's work. For a moment, I almost believe it. The music falls short for a few seconds before starting up again. Wait, isn't this the same song again? Ah, it's probably an endless loop, because why wouldn't it be? Sure seems that way. Guess it's just ghosts on the waves, after all. And the undead aren't exactly interested in DJing. What would you think a zombie would even listen to? Is that metal too obvious of an answer? A Rob Zombie, or maybe they're all into baby metal these days? I don't know any of those types of music. Just go with the flow, Vlad. Just go with the flow. I don't know. I think the Grateful Dead seems more apart. You know, I've always wondered this, but what are they grateful for, exactly? Maybe they finally found themselves some peace. Peace, you know? I wish they'd left the rest of us have some. So it's a bit hard to read because the letters are rather close, and sometimes there may be two words that are a bit too close to each other and I don't really know what they mean. I ain't so bad right now, anyway. Well, except for that. I shake my hand at the radio controls. So, what are you into anyway? Music-wise, I really like Alanis Morissette, top 40 hits, that sort of thing. You? And don't tell me it's baby metal. Will you judge me if I say I actually haven't heard of them? No, that might be for the best. What do you listen to then?
I myself don't really listen to music in general.
Well, more like instrumental music, okay? Sometimes. When I'm really bored. Don't judge me. Actually, you know what? You can judge me whatever you can. There is a saying in Latin, De gustibus et de coloribus non disputatur. We can't argue about tastes and colors. Most people look at me and expect me to be into Stones or Marley or something, but, well, you'll probably actually judge me more for this. Try me. ABBA. Just as I thought, she starts laughing at my expense. It's a nice sound though. I'm not gonna be poetic and say that it sounds like music or anything like that. Still, it's good to hear. Told ya. No, it's fine. Their music's catchy.
I don't think I ever listened to ABBA.
I mean, my parents listen to ABBA, but it's fine.
Your parents? Yeesh.
How old are you anyway? You seem a bit young for Alanis. How old do you think I am? I'm pretty sure there is no right answer to that question.
Except that one.
Yeah, to be honest, I've been taught by television, but also it was a bit obvious, never to ask a woman's age if you want to live.
Except for that one.
I'm 22.
Shit.
God, that's so young. She's practically a kid. 22? Practically a kid? Come on! What was I doing when I was 22? Still wasting my life, I reckon. Wonder if she's even been to school. That young and the whole damn world's crashing down around her. I try not to make a face, but I can see my knuckles going white as my fingers grip harder into the wheel. This music's kinda similar to ABBA, isn't it? All peppy and stuff.
What?
Actually, you know what? Whatever. You should be happy to have it. That's sure an optimistic take on it. Yeah, I'm more of a pessimistic type of person. Alright, enough of you. Oh. Finally, it stopped. I was afraid that you couldn't hear me, and probably you couldn't. But unfortunately, my throat is sore. I reach down and turn the volume knob to a sharp left, and the radio blissfully goes silent. Farewell, wailing man. No, it's just us again. Look. Did you ever expect things to end up this way? It's getting dark, huh? The sun sets so late in the summer.
Ignore me, huh?
Sore topic, huh?
Ignoring me, dodging the question, are we?
Wonder what she was into before this. What she was into before this. Maybe she has always planned on the world drifting to her in a handbasket. Smoked away youth and whiled away her time.
Huh, no, that's me, ain't it?
I am a bit surprised we still have any light at all at this hour. So I guess Dustin didn't really know what to do with his life, and he's still searching for that thing. That one thing that he would enjoy, especially without the streetlights and all. It's like the sky's just been saving it up. Seriously, that T looks like an I. I'm sorry, but the text isn't that well made. There's not enough space between words, and the letters. Some letters aren't clear enough. Like that T. I wasn't even sure what it was until I realized that one line was missing. Looks a bit like a dying fire. Is it just me? Am I just blind or something like this? Or is the text actually hard to read? Kind of fitting for the end of the world. I don't know, sometimes it feels hard to read. Maybe it's because I'm tired right now. Who knows? Seriously, I can't stop yawning. I'm sorry for that. So you never really told me that it... what it is that you do. I mean, doesn't have to be a job or anything, but well, what do you like to do, or what did you before everything? Actually, I worked a lot.
I didn't really have time for much other than that.
Yeah, she looks like she worked on a fast food or...
No. She worked in a supermarket, because I can see this looks like an uniform, obviously, and I can see the shopping cart here. I think it's a shopping cart.
I would wake up, shower, go to work, have a lunch break, back to work, get off work, eat dinner and watch TV for a few minutes before passing out. And then the whole thing would start all over again in the morning. Poor girl. That was about it.
I guess that'd be most people's story. It's tough out there. Was tough probably to...
What? Sorry, my mind is a bit...
All kind of pointless in the end, isn't it? Your work, your damn tail off, and everything goes to pot anyway. And you just wonder why you didn't spend your time better, you know?
Yeah, but I guess that doesn't matter either way.
So what about you? I'm sure you didn't spend all your time listening to ABBA. I used to travel a lot, looking for work and stuff. I suppose you could call me a bit of a nomad.
Well, that sure is lofty.
That sounds really cliché,
Not really. It's a. It sort of suits you. To tell the truth, I haven't really had much purpose in a while. I've just been getting by. When you can't find something to do, you sort of lose yourself. It gets to a pretty dark place. Got to the point I used to wish I could just take a vacation from life. Guess I got my wish, didn't I? Wishes never do come true the way you expect them to, Yeah, monkey's paw. I don't think she knows, I've noticed, but she's been pressing at her gut a lot. Wonder if she's still alright. Since I first ran into her, she's been in a rough way, but I'm not sure it's gotten much better. He probably should have looked for some more bags of that ginger stuff. Ask if she's nauseous, comment on her hand. Comment on her hand. You okay there? I point toward her stomach with the back of my hand. Oh, yeah, it's gotten a little better, but I'm just exhausted, which doesn't help things. You know how it is. I do, but Christ, I'm really not equipped for this. I know first aid, I can stitch up a cut, but gastric distress, it's a bit beyond me. You think we should stop and rest? Nah, like it or not, we'll be stopping soon anyway. Breaking would just waste gas. Right, the fuel. If everything wasn't so weird these days anyway, I'd call it suspicious that there was only a single tank's worth left. Not much we can do about that though. Onward it is then. She doesn't look very good. Do you ever wonder, like, why us? Why did we make it this far? And it is really such a good thing that we're still alive? Didn't I used to? Honestly, I try not to think so hard about stuff like that. If I stop to wonder what my own life was worth, it's a dangerous train of thought, I'll tell you that. We're here, that's what matters. Despite it all, we're here, and we're safe. The how and why of it is just garnish on the salad. You know, I didn't believe it at first. I mean, that we were really facing the apocalypse or whatever. So the first couple months I just kept working, kept on like everything was fine. And then listen. You don't gotta answer if you don't want to, but your old man. What happened? My dad? So, he needed more beer, right? Of course he did. He was a deadbeat alcoholic. But they wouldn't even let him in our nearby liquor store anymore. So he wandered off to another one. Just so happened that that part of town was infested. It took a while before I even noticed, since it wasn't really any difference from usual. That's pretty pathetic, But so was my dad. And in the end, I won't be doing much better. Great, now I feel like I wanna puke. Hey, Please don't say things like that, Tana. One of us has to keep this up. Rest hand on hers, let her be. Rest hand off on hers, I guess. I'm not really that good at relationships with people. I mean, I can analyze them, experiment on them, dissect them. I slide my right hand off the wheel. Weren't you supposed to touch her hand, not her leg? Her hand is resting by her leg, near the center console, so reach over. Oh, I thought it was his hand. Sorry. Well, I guess it makes sense now. Her hand jerks when I touch it, but she doesn't pull away. God. Wow, her skin feels really cold. Is that normal? Maybe because the window's open? Maybe it's because she's sick? I wish I knew about more medical straight about now. Yeah, medical... what? Anyway. Actually, if she had a fever, shouldn't she be hotter? A chill like that can't be normal. It's not even that cold in here. But we're still here, just remember that. Until that changes, there's still time. Things might never get any better. I'd be stupid to assume that they would. But while we're still braiding, there's hope. Bah, that's pretty cheesy, isn't it? Anyway, I'm sorry about that. About your dad, I mean. Even if you didn't get on with him, I bet it must be hard. Losing someone that close to you. Yeah, I guess. It all happened so fast. I'm still trying to come to terms with it. I wouldn't worry too much. There's no wrong way to feel. I like that quote. I like that line. I guess I'm almost privileged. No one I care about has been around in a long while. I wonder if there's anyone else still out there. I wonder if they're stuck out there, like this. I wonder if we'll ever know. I don't know why, but the air feels colder. Maybe it's time to roll up the window. Hey! She doesn't look so good. So I just remembered something pretty funny. But nothing. She's bored of me already? A few weeks ago, I was running down this alley and I saw this old poster, right? Real beat up weather thing, but scraped on the corner of it. What is she looking at? Is she even listening? Wait. Hey, are you sure you're really feeling alright? Wait, is that something dripping for her mouth? Is that blood? What is it? Oh no, I think she got bitten or something like that. God, please say something. Maybe she was infected. Anna? She keeps staring forward at something, at nothing. Besides the glow of the headlights on the empty road, it's pitch black outside. There isn't a thing to see. But she hasn't fallen asleep. Her eyes are still open. The car gives a bit of a sputter. The gauge is on empty. Actually, the warning light's been on a while. Anna? Shit, come on now. I pulled to the side of the road. This rust bucket's on its last legs anyway. The engine cuts off with an appreciative sigh. Hey, talk to me. Do you need to puke or something? Anna. She says nothing. And sits still as a statue. I'm not even sure she's breathing. Do I touch her? I start to reach out my hand. Just then, she turns slowly to look at me. Oh no, something bad is going to happen. Of course, of course. Her mouth hangs. Her eyes are completely empty. She stares at me only, lifeless, and leans in closer. That. I should have seen this coming. Oh, come on! I knew it. I knew she was bad news. It's not fair! So she became a zombie, I'm pretty sure. It's not fair that he had to die. I grew a bit attached to Dustin. For some reason. Oh well. There's no point in crying over spilled milk. This was actually a really good story. I liked it. Well, I'll have to think about this a bit. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. I'm sorry if you couldn't hear me at certain points, but again, my throat is sore, and I just can't force my voice. I don't feel like I can force my voice. Anyway, thank you for your attention, my dear guests. And until next time, I'll be watching you.